Welcome to the Prolific Pulse Poetry Podcast. This is your host, Lisa Tomey. I am so happy to welcome Ashanti Anderson. Welcome, Ashanti.
Thank you for having me.
Now, I understand that you are in New Orleans, is that right?
Yep.
So how is it there?
It is exciting. I recently moved back after going through a bunch of school and moving about. And now that I'm back, I just feel like I'm rediscovering the city all over again. And it's really fun because I'm older now. So I see more, I notice more. It's a very enriching experience to go back to a place you've been before and just relearn it.
Probably changed a little bit. Has it been a number of years?
Yes. A few, maybe almost a decade.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, since I had been here for any period of time, you know. So yeah, a lot's changed. We were still, the first time I was here was after Katrina, and the city was, we were looking at like how it was recovering or how it wasn't recovering after Katrina. And that's interesting to then myself live through Hurricane Ida, actually having a home in New Orleans. And it's such a different experience to witness that catastrophe versus nearly being in one. So yeah, it's a lot, but I love New Orleans. I love the energy. So I'm really happy to be back.
Well, good. It's on my list of places to go one day.
Oh yeah, you have to. Yeah, it's so much fun. It's fun. You know, go during a good time, a safe time for you, you know, but definitely it's got to be on the bucket list for sure.
Well, if nothing else, I gotta try their beignets.
Oh yeah, nowhere else makes them the same. It's impossible.
Yeah, there's a place I used to live in Iowa and across the river from Omaha, and there was a place there that had the cuisine, and that was the first time I've ever tried a beignet. And I said, if no other reason, this is a good reason to go to New Orleans. But I also happen to love jazz, so I think that's another good reason to go.
Oh, yeah. I mean, do you need any more reasons?
I don't think so. That yeah. Works for me.
It's a great place.
Jazz, you know?
Yeah, the food and the history, the culture, the music. And usually it's all wrapped up in one, and that's such a great environment to be in, for sure.
Now, what's the poetry scene like there?
To be honest, I'm still getting my feelers out there. I recently became a university professor, and that's taken up way more of my time than I thought. Thank you. I'm just trying to do, you know, the best for my students and stuff. So yeah, I'm still wanting to connect with people. When I was here, you know, those years ago, it was very, I will call it communal, a communal environment. Everyone is happy to share and equally happy to listen. And that's a good place to be in a writing community like that.
Absolutely. There are still a lot of restrictions there regarding, you know, the pandemic and that are affecting going to venues.
Yeah, well, personally, I don't keep a ton of tabs on that because I'm on the stay-at-home side of the spectrum. But yeah. from my understanding, things have definitely laxed, but the mayor seems to be taking it very seriously and is trying to work with everyone where they are. Like, okay, you need, you know, the economy is stimulated, so your business is fine. You need entertainment so you don't like just feel miserable at home. And it's trying to like accommodate those needs, right? Oh. While also being mindful that, you know, it is, we are in a pandemic. So we also need to be willing to sacrifice a little. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, it sounds like they're pretty empathetic to what's going on. So I understand that congratulations are in order. You won this chapbook competition. Tell me about that.
Yes, yes. I won the Black River chapbook competition for spring 2020. This is hosted by Black Lawrence Press, a publisher of books, full length and chapbook. One of the great things about them is that they definitely don't distinguish between the two when it comes to time and attention for the work, which is something I appreciated because my little collection is only 30 pages small, but it took a lot of attention, and I'm happy to be with a press that also, you know, acknowledged and respected that.
Yes. Well, tell us about your book.
Yeah, so Black Under is my debut poetry collection. It's a chapbook that really grapples with the inconsistencies and contradictions of oppression, essentially, of being subjected to or, you know, assigned to be miserable, right? And how that's not all, right? Like, that's not all. We can find moments of beauty and joy, even despite all of that. And not sometimes not in spite of, but sometimes through that. And I'm really trying to explore that range of emotion that comes as a person who experiences, you know, oppression, discrimination, or any major, you know, ordeal, right, such as those.
Yeah, it's more apparent as days go by right now. Last night I had an open mic. I held for social justice, and we had quite a mix of poetry, spoken word, and it was really apparent to me there are so many different points of view, and all of them are so valid. And I think people are trying to find some kind of a peaceful resolution to what is not an easy thing to find.
Mm-hmm.
Well, how about you share one of your poems with us?
Yeah, for sure. I think in honor of the open mic, I think I want to read Acrostic for My Last Breaths. It seems like it would have fit in good there. Acrostic for My Last Breaths. If I'm ever out of oxygen, cut the comms, switch the radio, play a song by Whitney or Aretha, something no sense can pause my throat from parting for. Gon' throw my sorrows into this vast black void that don't even have space to hold tune or blues, but I don't sing to be heard. I do it to keep on. Ring diaphragm and rattle lung like sickness, each eighth note a reason to stay living. Can't take a rest. Might hear the censors whining, that worried, heaving falsetto of siren. How I hate the sound of dying. Rather riff, even if everything in me stops screaming.
Well, well. May we never be called to play those for you.
Maybe, hopefully, right?
Yes, absolutely. Yeah, beautiful. I had the pleasure of absolute pleasure is actually putting it mild, a dream fulfilled of seeing, listening to Aretha Franklin years ago at Myrtle Beach. And oh my goodness, I thought I had died and gone to heaven. I thought my experience with B.B. King was a died and gone to heaven experience, but Aretha, wow, that was amazing. So yeah, I could certainly connect. If we're going to leave this world, let it be with a melody from Beautiful Songbird. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Absolutely. Well, that certainly gives pause for thought. Yeah. Would you like to share another one of your poems?
Yeah, for sure. I'll read Cleaning Up Men's Messes. Cleaning up men's messes. What of this woman's work? It pays unwell, the daily sweep of bread and glass crumbs. Grandkids think I'm picky because I'm always fussing them for even how they walk, sliding feet, scooting my rugs. Just don't want them to notice the cold blood stain on the carpet beneath, seeped as I grieve long before pouring isopropyl alcohol libation. I wipe counters clean of catsup and remember glass bottles and hock spit lobbed like Molotov cocktails, porcelain plateware broken across the backs of skulls of school kids. Built my house with bricks thrown through my window. When not cleaning commodes or windows or open wounds, there is much to be sewn. Busted knee needs patching, shirt gnawed by dogs or asphalt, buttons ran off in another man's fist. Once I'm done with that, I still got to cook a meal we can all sit down for. Ben learned, cold beer move a man much as any fire hose. How I was raised, women should be felt, not heard. Reverse must be true for men. If not the ring of a bomb so close it fevers your ear, it's whiskey thick threats. Every night I hear somebody else's sliding feet along my neighbor's driveway. Guess they think being strong means throwing their weight around or starting fires or coming home to hit women. But men ain't too much different from us. I too find myself trying hard not to love a man. We all bend to the will of hard water, know how hard it is to sleep with a sink full of broken dishes, windows, skulls.
Yeah. Prolific. Absolutely. I was reading that earlier. It's like such imagery. I mean, It just takes my breath away. It speaks so true to what people struggle with. You really express yourself in such a prolific way.
Thank you. Yeah, I try to focus on those images that capture that feeling. I think that is the gift of poetry. Some poets are very, very beautiful storytellers in a narrative sense. But for myself, I feel like it's easiest for me to carry the message on the back of an image. Mm-hmm. Like it explains it better. It articulates it better than just my mere narration
right
could do. Yeah.
Yeah, we definitely all had different ways of getting that expression out. And I like that variety. Yeah. I like that. I love your poetry. I need to purchase that book. Definitely need to put that one up on my shelf for reading. So Oh, goodness. Do you have another one for us?
Yeah, I can read another one.
Thank you.
I have one in mind.
Okay.
Resignation. This, my 2 week notice. I am tired with comparing my body to heavy things, of holding death like my grandmother's house. I erased my smile in another poem because someone said it made no sense. Understand, I am done writing about the Black girl emptied. I'm off to find a brown boy with his ghost still in him. Last week, I slipped and busted my mouth on asphalt, and if you want the blood, I will have for you my red, wet grin.
Thank you. Do you have another book that you're working on?
Yes. Actually, I'm working on a few things, so don't hold me to any strict deadlines.
I understand that.
But yeah, my next collection is more so explicitly focused on Black joy in particular, and the different ways that manifests through moments of pain or trauma. Specifically within the context of slavery. You know, how did these people manage to find joy? Was it in resistance? Was it in dissociation? Was it in community? And really trying to explore that through poetry.
Well, that sounds interesting. That'll be a, yeah. So have you started writing some poems for that?
Yes, I have. It's probably one of the most fun things I've ever worked on.
Oh, wow. Well, that's awesome.
Yeah, when you know the mission is to capture joy, you literally have to feel it yourself in order to make sure that you're capturing the right thing.
Absolutely.
So I can't come in writing, you know, and if I'm getting in a bad mood, then that's a sign I might be writing about something I shouldn't be for this collection. So it's also a great thing to turn to while I'm working on other projects, just to have my moment of just joy and trying to relive that and feel that, so I can bring that up for whoever the speaker is in the poem.
Mm-hmm. Now, someone wants to follow you and find out how you're doing and where you're going with this. Where would they find you?
They can, actually, the best way is my newsletter. You can find it on my website, ashanticreates.com. I would say social media, but that's honestly a better option for the less involved, because that's not a skill of mine. If you want to really stay up to date, and also a little behind the scenes of what I'm working on and how that's progressing and stuff like that, that gets sent to folks' inboxes as an update about once a month. And I don't have a no reply feature. So folks often reply back, and we keep in touch with each other that way.
Great. Yeah, wonderful. Is there anything I haven't asked you that you would like to share?
Honestly, not that I could think about. This has been a really pleasant conversation. I've really enjoyed it. And I like to be in the present with people and in moments. I didn't have any particular thing I wanted to promote. I think if folks really enjoyed the poems, then I just hope they buy the book, and I hope they talk to me about it.
Okay. And I'll put your links too into the show notes so people can click on those and find you and follow you and buy your book. And Yeah, great. I had actually seen your book listed a while back on the pre-sale, and I was just scouring the internet, and yeah, so it's interesting how we just kind of connected after that. So.
Yeah, I'm very happy for it. I'm very happy. Yeah, I'm very proud of this book. So I'm happy to talk about it anytime.
Right. Well, thank you so much, and you have a wonderful rest of your day.
Thank you, likewise.
Thank you.